Hi y'all, welcome to my little channel here on YouTube. Let me start off saying I am sorry, but my voice is a bit hoarse. I've been sick and it's taking me a little while to get my voice back, but I just couldn't wait any longer to do this video. Today I have the haul from my last Thrift With Me video, and I think I may title this Better Late Than Never. Sorry, it's been a rough month and I just didn't have time to upload and edit this video. So without further ado, let's get into it. As you can see here, it's not a ton, but still a decent haul if I do say so myself. We're starting off first with this Norman Rockwell mug. And it's got a little child watching his grandfather build a ship. This mug was in great condition and very nostalgic of the 80s when Norman Rockwell was popular. Well, that was back in my day. The back says, as the little boy strains to peer over his grandpa's work table, the old sea captain deliberately and with great skill puts the finishing touches on a model sailing ship. It's a great amount of work, but it's worth doing for a good boy. And it's dated 1985 by the Norman Rockwell Museum. I thought it would fetch a decent amount, but when I got home, the comps weren't the best on it, which is sad because it's a nice quality mug with a classic American image on it. But hey, that's okay. I still love it, and I hope it finds a forever home. I only paid $1.50 for this, so I'll at least make a couple of dollars. Next up are these beautiful hand-painted vintage porcelain ashtrays by Lefton, made in Japan. I just love them. The dainty flowers and the gold gilded flourishes. It reminds me of old world English porcelain. You know, the kind that you would find back in the Downton Abbey days. Love Downton Abbey. Anyways, I picked these up for $2 each. And looking at the comps, I may start off listing these for about $15 each. No matter what, they are gorgeous. Now, this little candle holder was a surprise to me. I really don't know why I gravitated to it, but when I ran the comps on it, I was surprised at the resale prices. This little thing depicts the three wise men bearing gifts for the baby Jesus. It's a vintage and made in Japan by a company called Commodore. I don't know if you've ever heard of it. I haven't. And it's definitely hand-painted. I only paid $1 for it, but most of the prices I see are between $10 and $30 that it's reselling for. There was one listing I found for $5, but even if I eventually have to sell it for that price, at least I'm making a profit. I think I'll start off at around $12 and go down from there. I picked up this beautiful little vintage creamer for $1.50. Now, I couldn't find an exact match for it, but ones that look similar ran for about $20 to $40. Unfortunately, you can't tell it on the screen, but when I got it in bright light, I could tell there was a large area on the creamer that was discolored. It's faint, but in the right lighting, you can really see it, so that will drastically affect the price that I can sell it for. Thankfully, I only paid $1.50, so it won't be much of a loss if for some reason it doesn't sell. We'll see how it goes. Next up is this adorable old man. Look at him. It's a hand-painted vintage figurine. I think he's a grandpa and he's building a toy ship. That face, I love it. You know what? I just thought of this. This would be so cute sold with the Norman Rockwell mug. I may do that. If they don't sell individually, I may end up selling it as a set. Anyways, this was made by Norleans in Japan and is reselling between $30 to $50. I think I'll put them in my booth for about $25 for a quicker sale. These two glasses were so interesting I had to get them. They remind me of vintage frosted highball glasses that I remember a lot of people in the 70s would own. I think my parents may have had some as well, with a different image, of course. What I found interesting about these are the image on them. It turns out that these are Norman Baxter glasses, commemorating the 150th anniversary of the San Jacinto Monument in Houston. The back gives a brief history of the monument, and both glasses are in great condition. From what I remember, I think I paid 50 cents for each glass, but it looks like they're reselling between $8 to $15 each. So I think I'll start off selling them as a pair for about $18. That sounds good, don't you think? Maybe? We'll see. This mug here brings back such happy memories. My parents loved taking me to the Barnum and Bailey Circus, and I loved going. It was just a wonderful time back then. Wish that I could share them with my children. But anyways, I digress. Actually, I think I even had this very mug when I was a kid. But needless to say, just for the nostalgia alone, I had to buy this mug. It's a 1988 pink Ringling Brothers and Barnum & Bailey 3D plastic mug for only 50 cents. It was hard to find comps on just the pink elephant, so I'm guessing it's rarer than the regular gray elephant mug. From what I found, they're selling these between $4.99 to $19.99. And as you can see, I don't always buy things that will bring me a lot of money. Sometimes, like this, I buy for the nostalgia and the memories that an item brings to me. And for 50 cents, the little spark of joy this gives to me, to have it for just a little while is all worth it. As you can already see on the screen, I purchased this beautiful hand-painted Japanese teacup. I actually thought it was a sake cup, but after researching it, I realized it's not. It's a teacup. I was just drawn to the beautiful Japanese scene on it and the pink coloring and the glaze that almost looks iridescent in certain lighting, but my camera lighting was not the best and did not do this any justice at all. Anyways, I bought this for $1.50 and was shocked when I went home and ran the comps. I mainly saw it sold as a pair of teacups from $32 to $98. So for one, it would be between $16 to $49. That's incredible. Of course, with only one teacup, I'll start it at the lower end, maybe $15. Is that too low? What do you think? Let me show you the most precious item in my haul. Emphasis on the word precious. Look at this cutie. She's a 1985 Precious Moments figurine entitled May Your Christmas Be Happy. Although it looks more like it would be celebrating a birthday rather than Christmas. But anywho, it's made by Inesco and it's a porcelain bisque little girl clown holding a balloon. Seriously, it is so precious. I just can't stop saying that. It's too cute to sell. I'm thinking I may keep this, and when my granddaughter gets big enough, I may give this to her as a gift or use it as a birthday topper. Who knows? But she's definitely a keeper. Now, this next item had an unfortunate mishap. When I picked it up at the thrift store, I was so excited to find out that this was made by Lennox. I just couldn't wait to get home and put new batteries in it and see how it looks all lit up. Unfortunately, when I turned it upside down to replace the batteries, the little star bumped my kitchen counter. And it wasn't even a hard bump, it just barely grazed it. But apparently this tree was made out of glass and broke easily. I had no idea it was glass. I thought it was made of plastic because it felt like plastic and it was lightweight and even looked like plastic. But of course, I was terribly wrong. I guess I'll try gluing this back together and hopefully you can't tell it's broke. Here's another item that I had to buy because of the memories it triggered when I saw it. Just a quick backstory. When I was 7, I went to London, England with my parents on vacation, and I was so fascinated by the beautiful old buildings and all the sights that I saw and the local Londoners that I fell in love with England. So anything that reminds me of England sparks a little joy in my heart. That's why when I saw this little goose, I had to have him. He's dressed up like a vintage police officer known as a Bobby, and he was made in 1986 in Malaysia by UNESCO for the Mother Goose line of Waddleville Country porcelain figurines. And I think he's just adorable, writing up a ticket with his little billy club hanging on his belt. I'm still on the fence whether I'm going to keep him or not, but he was just too cute to leave behind. This next item will be a keeper for me, among so many other things. I love anything in a cloche, especially if it's a Christmas scene. If I'm remembering right, I think I thrifted a Christmas cloche with either a vintage ice skater or maybe it was a vintage snow angel in one of my thrift haul videos. And I think that cloche was made by the same company as well, Alda Sentimental Living. I remember looking that up, and from what I remember, that company is no longer in business. So I'm including some comps of similar cloches that range from $10.99 to $48, but I really don't think that I'll be parting with this anytime soon. Next up are these pretty vintage Bailey's lowball glasses. Wouldn't these look great on a bar cart? Just looking at them, I knew they'd sell for a decent amount, especially since they only cost 50 cents each. I love the gold bubbles on these, and I don't think I'll have a hard time selling these at all. They're in excellent condition. This plate was one of those too pretty to leave behind purchases. And for a dollar, I couldn't go wrong picking this up. This is a vintage pressed glass bread plate with a sunflower petal and cross design. Such a pretty little plate. I'm going to have difficulties parting with this. Here's another cutie. Luckily for the size, I won't be keeping this because my Christmas bins are too full to store this adorable picture. But look at that sweet face on the snowman, and he's got three little snow kids surrounding him with a precious little squirrel on his scarf. Oh, it's like cuteness overload. The picture says this was made in Indonesia, but that's all I know about it. Not sure who made it. It almost looks like it could have been made by Lennox, but they usually mark their items. Can you believe I only paid $3 for this? That's a nice score, if I do say so myself. Okay, this next item will be the last of me using the word cute. There's just not a better word that I can think of because look at how cute this is. I just could not pass him up. Look at this little farmer, or I think it's a gardener, bunny rabbit. Anyways, I'm just in love with that face. Heck, I just love the whole thing. Like, look at the overalls he's got on. This large cookie jar is made by Treasure Craft, and as much as I want to keep him to display during Easter, like my Christmas bins, my Easter bins are maxed out as well. So I'll have to let him go. But to be honest, if he doesn't sell, I won't be that sad if I end up having to keep him. I'm just saying. And last but not least are these three frosted glass tumblers with hand-painted daisies all over and the word January written in script. I think these are so pretty. They are vintage anchor hocking glasses, and I paid 50 cents for each glass. I had intended to sell these, but the thrift store wrote in permanent marker at the bottom of the glasses. I hate it when they do that. I tried everything to get the price off. Alcohol, fingernail polish remover, and even a magic eraser, and nothing works. I think maybe because of the frosting on the glass is why I can't remove the permanent marker. I'm really not sure. Does anyone have any ideas? If so, please let me know in the comments. So for now, I'm keeping these. Any ideas will be appreciated. Well, friends, that was my entire haul. How do you think I did? Good? Bad? Let me know below. Of course, my taste won't be the same as yours, but it's always nice to hear the different views. And if you ever want me to look out for something for you while thrifting, let me know. And let's see, as time allows, I'm going to try to drive a bit further and check out more thrift stores and antique malls to see if I can find more treasures. So stay tuned for those thrifting adventures. And hey, if there's anything you see here that you may like, just let me know and I can give you a price on the item and ship it to you. Lastly, if you like my video and want to see more like this, please hit the thumbs up and subscribe. I work full time, so the content that comes out may be a bit sporadic for now, but if you subscribe, then YouTube will let you know when a new video comes out. Anyway, I really, really appreciate you taking the time to watch this today, and I just can't say thank you enough. Until next time, I hope you have a wonderful day. Blessings and all my love to you all. See you soon in the next video. Bye.